This video is brought to you by the CMU Global Communication Center and will help you learn how to design more informative and engaging slide presentations using a research-based model. Take a look at these three slides. What's your reaction? Now look at these same three slides, which we've revised according to a research-based model. Which do you prefer? If you like the revised slides better, you're not alone. Studies have shown that people prefer this template over conventional PowerPoint slides at a rate of 7:1. Studies have also shown that this model significantly increases reader comprehension and retention. In this video, we will go over the most common mistakes people make when designing PowerPoint presentations. Then, we will explain this research-based model and show you examples to help you learn how to create effective, engaging slides of your own. Think back to the PowerPoint presentations you've seen over the past few months. Chances are, many were unengaging or hard to follow, but why? First, let's break down the main issues with standard slide design. The first problem is too much text. Slides crammed with dense concentrations of text can overwhelm audiences and make them not want to read the information you're trying to share with them. Similarly, unnecessary visuals that don't contribute meaningfully to your message can distract or confuse audiences who aren't sure what they're supposed to learn from them. The root cause of these problems is the default slide model, which consists of a phrasal heading and fragmented bulleted lists, like these. This standard model is wonderful at helping the speaker recall her talking points. In fact, a nervous or unprepared speaker can simply read from the screen. But this format fails miserably in helping the audience understand and absorb the main points of a presentation. That's because this conventional template of PowerPoint, a phrasal title and a bulleted list, doesn't help the audience understand the bottom line or main message of a presentation. Without a big picture message, the audience won't understand how the individual pieces of your slide fit together. Instead, when audiences are looking at the slide, they want to be able to quickly get the big picture, then listen to you further explain the details and how they work together to support that main message. Without this framework, audiences can end up feeling so overwhelmed by the information you're giving them that they miss the point of your presentation entirely. Besides making it hard for audiences to identify the main message, text-heavy bulleted slides are also hard to process at a cognitive level. To experience this for yourself, take a look at this slide while I'm talking and pay attention to what your brain is doing. When I'm saying this, you cannot simultaneously process my verbal narration and the textual words on the screen. Physically, you cannot cognitively process both at the same time, so you'll either be toggling back and forth but missing some key information, listening to me and not really understanding the text, or just reading this text and zoning me out. So what are you doing? Phew! If you're like most people, you're probably trying to toggle back and forth. Why is that? This is your brain. Visual and verbal inputs are processed by two different areas of your brain. Because of that, you can process both inputs, the image and the words, at the same time. In fact, you're doing that right now. You're hearing the words I'm saying and mapping them onto this concept. However, people cannot process two verbal inputs at the same time. So when I'm talking while you're trying to read a text-heavy slide, you try to toggle back and forth. It can be done, but consider how hard it would be to sustain that level of exertion throughout, say, an hour-long presentation. Most audiences get tired when trying to juggle text-heavy slides and complex oral explanations and will start to tune out. So, we've established that common PowerPoint slides are ineffectively designed because they confuse and overburden their audiences. So how can we fix it? We can fix crowded, fragmented, and ineffective slides using the assertion evidence model of slide design, which was developed by Dr. Michael Alley as a far more effective way to present your information. Alley's assertion evidence model contains two main parts, a message distilled into a complete sentence heading, and visual evidence that emphasizes that message. So, instead of making your audiences guess or work hard to identify the main idea of the slide, you give your audience the main idea along with the visual evidence to persuade them. This allows them to confirm, not discover, the main points of your presentation. Of course, you don't stop there. Once your audience gets the bottom line, you can then layer on more details and information verbally. Presenting your audience with the bottom line before adding the details gives your presentation coherence and focus, and makes it easier for the audience to understand your main idea. And this is actually backed up with research. But why the complete sentence? Well, people process information in units of meaning. What is a unit of meaning? A sentence, a subject, and a verb. You can find evidence of this if you take a look at a newspaper. Every headline is a complete sentence because people communicate meaningful thoughts in sentences, not in abstract phrases. Now you try it. Take the following slides, spend some time reading through them, and then see if you can draft an assertion headline for each of them. Remember that this is a complete sentence with a subject and a verb that sums up the main message of each slide. Pause your video for as long as you need to complete this task. If you're completing this video as an assignment, don't forget to bring your answers to your next class. Your answer is probably valid as long as you have a complete sentence that is relevant to the slide. Now, you may have questions, since this model is fairly new. We'd like to go over a few common questions here, but feel free to email gccmu@andrew.cmu.edu to discuss further. One thing you might be wondering is, are there any exceptions? Any reasons to deviate from this model? Yes, of course there are. The assertion evidence model is a tool, not a rule. You can take these guidelines and adapt them based on your audience and based on your project. For example, you might choose to break from the assertion evidence model for a method slide, an overview slide, or a slide that presents your thesis or hypothesis. You could modify the model to present your audience with a question rather than an assertion or claim. Or you might choose to forego a headline altogether if you have an important visual that you want to emphasize to your audience. Conversely, you may choose to omit a visual if you want the audience to focus exclusively on the words you have on screen. Consider that if you think you do need a list or words to communicate your point, you may be able to do the same thing but better using SmartArt, or a graphic that shows some sort of visual relationship. But what if you work in the humanities? In many cases, there might not be a way to visualize the point you're making. Instead, you might present a piece of text or a quote in lieu of a visual. Keep in mind, if you have a lot of details to share, that just because those details are on a slide doesn't mean your audience will grasp them. Instead, try delivering details verbally or providing a handout to accompany your slides. Just remember, audiences remember messages, so ask yourself, what's the main idea, the bottom line? What do you want your audience to take away from your presentation? Think about what your audience needs and be deliberate when choosing what to include. It's up to us, the next generation of researchers, to develop better, more effective ways of communicating to our audiences. This model is just one way that research is shown to be effective. Why don't you try it now? Here are some examples of slides that adhere to the old model. Using the assertion evidence model, can you revise these slides to make them more informative and engaging? You'll need to draft a complete sentence to serve as a heading. Then, choose or create a visual to best support their message. Try using clip art, smart art, or shapes available on PowerPoint. You can also do a search for stock photos, but be aware of using and circulating copyrighted material. Pause your video for as long as you need to complete this task. If you're completing this video as an assignment, remember to bring your ideas with you to your next class or submit them per your instructor's guidelines. We hope you found this video useful. Remember that the GCC is here to help you with all of your communication needs. To book an appointment with one of our tutors, visit our website. While you're there, you can click the Access Video tab to see more of our tutorials. Thanks for watching!